Hey guys, Andrew here, also known as SlayRocker86, and I know I kinda haven't been making a shiz loads of videos every single day, and I apologize for that, guys. I got shot in the nuts by a gorilla. I don't want to talk about it, but yeah, back to the video. So, as you guys can see, it is Minecraft 1.3.1, and I could have made a video on the pre-release or the snapshots, and I did, but you know what? I kinda wanna make a video right now for 1.3.1, even though it is the exact same thing. And let's just talk about some of the things that are in here. Let's look at options. I don't know if there's anything new in here, but who cares? Let's look at that. Yeah, there you go. Options. Now, I know a ton of new things that are in here. Let's look at this stuff. Language changes. I know they did change some of this, but the pre-releases for 1.3 are going all the way back from early, I think it's, not early, late March, April, May, June, and finally released, and actually, no, not even released in July, the day after July ended, August 1st. So yeah, it is August 1st as I speak. It is 1.3.1, and let's start. Multiplayer. No servers are going to start working, obviously, because none of them are updated to 1.3.1, because they only gave us a little bit less than a week to update for 1.3.1, which Bucket isn't totally ready yet, which, damn it, man, why? But, okay, whatever. I'm a little bit hyper right now because I took a little bit of Coca-Cola, and yeah. So, let's go into single player so we can show off all the new things. Create a new world. So, we got hardcore, we got creative, we got survival. Let's go on creative. More world options. This is what has changed. We have large biomes, and large biomes is what it is. It's larger biomes. So, yeah, large biomes. Bonus chest is now available for all you noobs that don't know how to do crap. You can have bonus chest, and it'll put a chest basically with all the default basic simple items that you might need. So I don't need that because I'm not an idiot. Now, generate structures on or off. That's
yes,
usual.
You are.
Just shut up, Ryan. He's in a Skype call. He's being a turd. Okay, so generate structures. That's, I think that's always been there. That's, you know, spawn dungeons, villages, all that crap. And then allow cheats. This is new. So now, if you're in the game, you can do commands like slash game mode, and then 1 or 0 or 2. They also added adventure mode, which I gotta show you guys that, because that's gonna be amazing for Hunger Games servers, or just for in general, because that's awesome. And slash XP, a bunch of other stuff that can help you. And then, of course, you could put this seed right here. Now, let's go to create a new world. Loading this whole world up. It's gonna take a little bit. Some of the new things they added is temples. It's amazing. The whole new creative system or inventory is like awesome. Okay, the game loaded up. That was a bit laggy. And let's see myself. Oh, it is me officially in 1.3. How you guys doing? Okay, let's go get out of this mode. Dooba dooba dooba. Oh, ta-da! Look at the new inventory. Okay, inventory is amazing. So now you can actually hit this search items and you could type anything. Anything. And okay, never mind. I meant to type books, not boobs, books. So there we got. Books, shelves, but well, let's type in book. There we go. We got book of quilling. What is a book of quilling, you may ask? Let's go on to it. Let me get out of this. Right click on it. You can write a live story. There are 50 pages available for this. So let's write the story of Ryan the Turtle. Okay, let's go with next page. Hit the next page button. Okay. Page 1. He died. That's all. Done. And once you're done, you've got the book. Pretty much. Now right click on it again. You can edit it. Now, if you want to do something stupid, but kind of smart, you could sign it. Now by signing it, this makes the book uneditable in the future. So you could basically finish a book, give it to somebody, and it's going to be signed, so they won't be able to edit it, so it'll be like a book they could read, but they could throw it in lava, and it'll be gone forever, which actually, if you throw it in lava without signing it, it'll be gone forever. But you're going to want to double check before you sign it, because it's gone forever. So, enter book title, the, I gotta think
I
of
like
this.
I like this Ryan the Turtle character, he really speaks to me.
Shut up, Ryan. The Ryan Turd. Turd. There we go. By SlayRock86. Note, when you sign the book, it will no longer be editable. Crap. Let's sign and close, and there we go. I've got a book now that I can read forever and right-click it, and I can't edit, but I can read it, and there's 50 pages that you can go up to, and yeah. Now, real quick, let me double-check something, make sure everything is working good for my computer. It is. Now, look at this. When you hit the escape key, you can now open to land. Yes, open land. This is basically like having a server for your land. If you guys do not know what land is, it is for Lee Anus Ninjas. Actually, no. Ryan, mute your mic. I don't want to hear your dogs. Okay, so start LAN. LAN is basically for your LAN network, and I don't know how to explain that in any other way because I'm an idiot. But LAN is basically if you have any of your friends coming over and having a LAN party. Nerds, I'm kidding. I do it every time. Actually, I don't because I don't have friends in real life. Because all I do is play with my cat in online videos. Okay, so LAN networks. Let's say you have an annoying brother. You guys both don't have a server. Let's say your internet exploded, and you guys want to. Well, actually, no. I don't know if it'll work if your internet exploded. It's LAN based, so it should be able to. I don't know. Okay. So LAN will basically be able to connect and make kind of like a server. People will be able to join your single player if they're in your household in the same network. So yeah, that's basically the way you could set it up. And you could set it so it's creative, survival, adventure. Oh my god, look, it's adventure mode. And yeah, survival, creative, adventure, all that great stuff. Let's go back to creative. And you could allow cheats and all that good stuff. So yeah, I'm not gonna start a LAN network. Well, actually, let's start it. Well, yeah, now people can jo- Oh, snap, people. Oh, wait, no, that's not even my IP. I was gonna say, crap, crap. They see my IP. They see. Oh, ha ha. You don't see it anymore. Actually, you do. Crap. Okay, let me go to options, save and quit. Open LAN. It's already open. So yeah, other cool things. Chat settings. We got the chat settings right here. I don't know what this really does. Web links on off. I don't know what this does, but whatever. Okay then. So let's show some of the other really cool stuff about this. Let me get out of this stoop. No, bad, 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 bad. There we go. Okay, inventory, new things that have been added. They've added some really sweet things. So, okay, here we got block of emerald, which is actually probably going to be one of the new most rarest blocks to have. Now we got emerald ore. Now emerald ore is something I'm happy that they did add because they made it extremely rare. Now the thing that I love from Minecraft back in the older days is gold used to be really rare, and I'm talking about like a year and a half ago, back in like March, gold was rare as hell. But the thing about gold is that it was a very necessary product because you need it for power rails, and power rails require gold. And you need a lot of power rails for roller coasters and stuff, which made it so that people had to kind of spawn power rails in or gold in because gold was just such a hard thing to find. And I mean, let's face it, gold is useless for everything. I mean, weapons, really, they don't last long. They're kind of cool, but eh. Golden apples, eh. So power rails is their only use, so they kind of bumped up the rarity of it, and, or not really bumped it up, but made it less rare, whatever you call it. So yeah, gold is no longer that rare. So
made it more common.
Made it more common, whatever. So yeah, emerald ore is now like a rare find, and lapis is still kind of rare. Diamond is of course rare, but it's not that rare. You could find diamond if you're actually trying, unless if you're a noob or you're extremely unlucky. Now there's something that's like extremely rare, and I'm not talking really rare like a stronghold. I've never found a stronghold naturally in real life. Like I was in a server with two friends, and I've ran across them, but I've never like been mining and actually found one myself. So that's one of those things that I'm glad they added emerald ore. Now let's scroll down here, see if we find anything else. Nothing else that really interests me. I think they may have added some new blocks. I don't really know some of these default ones. Doesn't really matter. I've got some awesome stuff to show you guys in just a sec. Let me see if I could see anything really cool in here. Ooh, snow. I never realized that. Now you can have the snow. Oh, here's. Oh, ender chest! Ender chest! I wanted to show you guys this. Okay, wait. Also, the ender portal is also available here. You could always spawn that in, but now it's over here. Okay, whatever. Let's talk about the ender chest. And I know I showed this off before. But ender chest. Look at that. I could put something there. And there we go, it's in there. Do ba do ba do ba do. Put another ender chest here. And oh my god, it's in there. Take the emerald out. And then you go over here and you look in there and there's nothing in there. And you could break that one and you could break this one. And then you could break that one and you could put something in this one. And then you have it there. And then you break it and it doesn't break and there's no chest. But then you put one down and oh my god, it's there. So awesomeness. There we go. That's how that magical thing works. It saves into some online system in the game. Double checking my video didn't crash because it's crashed so many times. Double checking. Don't pay attention to the screen. Birds. Think about birds. Think about birds. Okay, the video's recording. I was double checking because I usually have it to me all the time. I make an amazing video and then it dies on me. I'm a little bit hyper right now. I'm not going to lie. I apologize. So, redstone. What new stuff is in redstone? You're going to love this. Tripwire hook. Tripwire hook. I'm not shizzing you guys. You're going to love Tripwire Hook. Then we got a redstone lamp so you guys could see the power of the Tripwire Hook. I'm also going to need to find me some string. What's new in this area? Nothing. This is miscellaneous. I should be able to find myself the string in here. I don't see the string in there. Let's look in materials. Ahaha! I found me some string. And is there anything new in materials? Yes, there is. There is an emerald, and you use this to trade with villagers. Because, yes, you could trade stuff now with villagers. So, there you go. That's an emerald for you guys. Nothing really too special about it. Who really cares? Anything else special in here? There's charcoal. There's coal. Blah, blah, blah. Potions or brewing. Now, they're taking advantage of the fact that so many people don't know how to make potions. There you go. They have them available. Splash potions, strength, all this awesome stuff. So, yeah, a lot of people normally Don't know how to work potions or all that. So now they have them simply available here, as well as XP is now so much easier to get. Armor, it's all the same. Nothing has really changed. Give us a new armor thing. Come on, something cool, a new weapon, like nunchucks. We need nunchucks. Something sweet like that. Okay, what else? Ooh, survival inventory. Yeah, this shows your. Ooh, you could actually put your armor on right there, straight from there. Awesome. And then you could destroy inventory. I'm not gonna do that because I want to destroy my inventory. But yeah, instantly add your inventory. Also, something really cool. Let me go over here. If you let me put that in. There, let me go to survival inventory again. Hold shift and you could instantly put your armor on. Actually, I just realized I need to be on survival, but whatever. Yeah, now if you hold shift and it'll instantly put your armor on. Before, you would hold shift and it would move things around, but it wouldn't put your armor on. Now you can do that. So yeah, fun little fact. Let's go to the tripwire stuff with string and stuff with things. Okay, let's find a good flat area. Okay, we got a good flat area over here. Let's put you block right over there and you right over there. Let's put the hook right here. The hook right here. You put the invisible. Wait, where's the string? Invisible string. Look at that. Look at that. If you don't even expect it, you're not gonna hit it. You're gonna be like, doo ba doo ba doo ba doo. Look at that. Redstone signal. Redstone signal. Didn't even see that. Now, of course, people are obviously gonna make a texture pack that's gonna make this extremely noticeable so that, you know, traps no longer work so well. But who cares? It's awesome. And look at the animation. You can see the tripwire hook. Oh, look at how it goes down. That is just amazing. I know. I've been playing Minecraft so much. Like, I can't even imagine when I go back into, like, Halo and Call of Duty for the new ones. I'm gonna be like, yeah, you know, this animation's awesome, but go to Minecraft. Look at that! The hook goes down and up and down and up. Like, seriously, Minecraft has lowered my standards for things, but I don't care because I love this game to death. Okay. Let's do something cool with that. Let's get some TNT. Go to my search. This is just going to help me so much better because I could just type TNT. There we go. I found the TNT. I love this new search engine thingy. Okay, let me get out of this. Let's put TNT right over there. Let's put the hook to that. I can't put the hook to that. Balls. I got an idea. Let's put the hook over here. Maybe the connection will work. Will it work? Oh my god, it worked. There we go. Simple trap. Boom, boom, boom. Blow up. There you go. You've got an easy, simple trap. So yeah, that's one of those new things, guys. We got books, we got that. Let me show you wood, because I am nowhere near a desert or a jungle biome, but they have added temples, they have added jungle, no, not, they have jungle temples, desert temples, and desert villages. So, real quick, let me show you something awesome. Let me, what was I gonna do? Wood logs. Oh, you guys are gonna like this. This is awesome. Now, this is gonna make cabins so amazing, so incredibly amazing. I got my wooden log right over here. Look at that! Oh my god, it's like a tree trunk just fell. Like, normally, this is the only direction that trees would be, which was boring. Now, you could make them go all different types of direction. This direction, this, no. This, there we go. Look at that. Why is this good? For one, you can make fallen trees. Not just that, but now you can make really cool type of cabins. I mean, I'm just saying, like, think of all the possibilities. You can make a cabin, like a wooden cabin with the logs, like, facing down in a nice pattern. I don't know, but wood now is just so much nicer. I'm just happy for this. Like, look at this. This is just awesome. I made a video privately talking about this, but, I mean, I just had to show it in this video. Look at the way you can do logs. That is just so simple, but it changes everything. That's what I love about Minecraft. Simple, stupid, easy, crap that makes everything incredible. That's what this is, guys. Okay. I'm running out of spit here, and I'm about to pass out, and I've had no sleep. And Ryan, you still there, Ryan? Say hello to the audience. Ryan, say something.
Hello. I'm no longer an alcoholic and slayer. You forgot upside-down levers. You forgot redstone with arrows and how much more sensitive it is. You can, like, shoot an arrow at a tripwire. You forgot that boat snap break lily pad. You forgot stars are much more epicer. You forgot pyramids and how epic they are.
I said pyramids. They're temples, okay?
Okay, you forgot the pyramid trap.
Oh, yeah.
I forgot jungle temples.
I said jungle temples. Jungle temples and desert temples are both traps. Oh, I'm spoiling it. I didn't want to spoil it for the audience, but there you go, guys. You have been spoiled. If you go into a jungle temple, it's actually, jungle temples are quite easy. There's tripwire. If you go to the left, after you go into the entrance in the left side, break that, and you will actually see a chest with really nice stuff. And in a desert temple, oh my god, desert temples are evil. Don't break the block in the middle. Do not break it. Break the block next to that, then jump down by putting sand down. It's easy, that way you could go down safely. Get the stuff. There's TNT all in the bottom. There's a pressure plate. You'll fall in the middle, so be extremely careful. I'm going to keep on talking.